Hey guys, this is Divya and I'm back with another episode of Personalities. Today presenting Gyani Zel Singh, who was born on 5th May 1916 and he died on 25th December 1994. Before I begin, I would like to request you to subscribe to Vaishya's channel and Vaish Courses if you haven't yet. Also, I would like to request you to watch the foundational videos made by Vaish sir before you watch these videos. And those videos are also available in Hindi. And you face any difficulty in your UPSC preparation, you need any guidance for your UPSC preparation, you can contact Vaish sir. And keep supporting by liking and sharing these videos. And don't forget to press the bell notification so that you never miss an update. Right? So, who was Gyani Zel Singh? He was the 7th president of India. He served from 1982 to 1987. And he was the first Sikh to hold this office. So, prior to his presidency, he was a politician with the Indian National Congress Party. And he held several ministerial posts in the Union Cabinet, including Home Minister. He also served as the chairman of the Non-Alignment Movement, NAM, from 1983 to 1986. Now we'll know about his early life. He was born in Sandhwan, Faridkot district on 5th May, as I told earlier, 5th May 1916, to Kishan Singh and Mata Hind Kaur in the princely state of Faridkot. Kishan Singh was his father, he was the village carpenter. Now his stint in state politics. In 1947, with the reorganization of India along secular lines, he opposed Harinder Singh Brar, ruler of Faridkot, and was incarcerated and tortured for 5 years. He was called on to be the revenue minister of the recently formed Patiala and East Punjab States Union under Chief Minister Gyan Singh Rerwala in 1949, and later he became Minister of Agriculture in 1951. From 3rd April 1956 to 10th March 1962, he was a member of the Rajya Sabha. Now his stint as Chief Minister of Punjab, that is from 1972 to 77. So he was elected as Congress Chief Minister of Punjab in 1972. He arranged massive religious gatherings, started public functions with a traditional Sikh prayer, inaugurated a highway named after Guru Gobind Singh, and named a township after the Guru's son. He created a lifelong pension scheme for the freedom fighters of the state. He repatriated the remains of Sardar Udham Singh from London, armaments and articles belonging to Guru Gobind Singh. Now his stint in central government. In 1980, Gyani Zel Singh was elected to the 7th Lok Sabha and appointed to the he joined Indira Gandhi's cabinet as Home Minister. He served beside Indira Gandhi, and protocol dictated that he should be briefed every week by her on the affairs of the state. On 31st May 1984, day before Operation Blue Star, he met with Indira Gandhi for more than an hour, but she omitted even sharing a word about her plan. Following the operation, he was pressured to resign from his post by Sikhs. He decided against resignation, fearing to aggravate the situation on advice of Yogi Bhajan. He was subsequently called before the Akal Takht to apologize and explain his inaction at the desecration of the Harminder Sahib and killing of innocent Sikhs. Indira Gandhi was assassinated on 31st October in the same year, and he appointed her elder son Rajiv Gandhi as Prime Minister. Also in 1986, he exercised the pocket veto with respect to the Indian Post Office Amendment Bill. This was passed by Rajiv Gandhi. And this bill was intended to impose restrictions on the freedom of press, and hence it was widely criticized. This bill was later withdrawn by VP Singh government. So this can be a question, it can be asked in your prelims, right? So he was the first one to exercise this pocket veto. Now his death and legacy. He died in PGI Chandigarh, where he had been undergoing treatment following a accident on Christmas Day, that 25th December in 1994, and he died at the age of 78. He was cremated at Rajghat Memorial in Delhi, and he, Zel Singh, on the 100 paisa India stamp issued in 1995, and a commemorative postage stamp was issued by India's Department of Post on the occasion of his first death anniversary in 1995. So with this we end this episode. Hope you enjoyed it. So we'll meet in the next one. Thank you so much for watching the video.